electronic votes, an army general named Gus Perna has been counting doses of vaccine. He's in charge of Operation Warp Speed, the catchy title given to the crash program to inoculate 300 million Americans against the coronavirus by next spring. For those of you longing to reclaim a semblance of your previous life, it may not seem all that speedy, but it is compared to the 5 to 10 years it usually takes to field a new vaccine. Once approved, it will not be a silver bullet. Just as with the annual flu shot, some of us will still get sick. That would give this country what it badly needs right now, a shot in the arm. A shot in the arm.
So if this distribution of vaccines doesn't go according to plan, where does the buck stop?
Me. Conversation's over. It's pretty easy. Me, I hold myself 100% personally accountable to that end. This collaboration, as we were going, there was no doctrine, there was no strategy, there was no structure of people to this end.
On his whiteboard is one possible scenario. The all-important approval by the Food and Drug Administration of a vaccine developed by Pfizer, followed by approval of another from Moderna.
What is D-Day?
The day that we deliver the first round of vaccine for Pfizer.
That's when it would start to get complicated, because if approved, the Pfizer vaccine will require patients to receive two separate shots 21 days apart.
We know it's a two-dose vaccine, so we want to ensure that we can manage the delivery of the first dose and ensure the delivery of the second dose while we simultaneously integrate new rounds of doses being delivered to the American people.
Are you ready to go if a vaccine is approved tomorrow?
Yes, we are.
What's the first order you're going to give?
It's a simple command of execute, execute.
So once you say execute, how fast does it get out there?
Within 24 hours, within 24 hours.
Do you have doses of vaccine already stockpiled?
Yes, we do.
How many do you have stockpiled?
I'm holding on to that number right now.
Are you worried about the security of the stockpiles?
We have taken extraordinary precaution in this area, not only for maybe some nefarious effort, but also natural, hurricane, tornado, etc. Right? It's such a commodity to us. We're taking the full steps to make sure that the vaccine is secure.
Armed guards?
Yes.
Armed guards at sites where the vaccine is stockpiled?
Yes.
Once it starts moving, whether on a truck or a plane, is it going to be under guard?
Yes. That's as far as I'm going to talk about it, though, right? Because you don't want to lay out all the plans, but the answer is yes.
And that no man might buy or sell save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the number of his name.
Will you be able to track all the moving parts?
Yes. I feel 100% confident of that.
Will you be able to bang your fist on the table and say what happened to that shipment that was going to Good Samaritan Hospital in Baltimore?
Yes. And not only that, I'll know after it gets there how fast they're administering the doses that they were given.
Perna's ability to do that depends on a software program called Tiberius, which is supposed to link databases from across the government and the shipping companies into one unified picture that everyone can see.
You can turn on where your hospitals are, where your pharmacies, your nursing homes, and where all of your enrolled providers are inside that jurisdiction.
But when Deacon Maddox, a newly retired Army colonel, briefed Perna on how ready Tiberius is for D-Day,
this capability didn't exist 2 months ago. So there's some things that we need to work through.
Deacon Maddox warned that once the vaccine starts flowing, the amount of data Tiberius has to keep track of will multiply.
What we're doing right now to get ready for the first dose is the easy part. When you get into the subsequent doses, that's when this gets really hard.
What's your worst nightmare?
We get vaccines to the American people and they don't take them. Shame on us. Hey, I was already sick. I don't need it. Shame on us. Hey, I don't believe in vaccines. Shame on us. Just shame on us. And it does keep me up at night.
Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666.